authority that the first St. Patrick's Day parade, which was 250 years ago, also had good weather.
I want to tell everyone I feel blessed, I feel happy, I am honored beyond. But we are marching for the people who have been marching for all these generations and for the mothers and fathers who let their children go. So we're marching for them. They're in the parade too. Catch them in the gallery. I know that.
She's the greatest Irish storyteller around.
So how are you on the 250th anniversary?
All right. Beautiful day for a parade.
Yeah.
250 consecutive years on this avenue, walking up Fifth Avenue. One block up, right up today, Barnes & Noble. They're selling like hotcakes. There's a big long line there. The best book out this year.
That's right. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Why
member of the European Parliament, and I represent Donegal and Sligo and Leitrim and Roscommon. And it's a fabulous day. Everybody's in good humour, and such a good day to be Irish today.
Don mentioned the book this year for the parade, the 250th anniversary of the parade. They wanted a book, so who published it? Quinnipiac University Press, and then Linguish Now, he said, the editor of that book. You know, March Madness has something to do with basketball. For the Irish, March Madness is this week, so I want you all to know you made my March Madness particularly exciting this year. This is the largest Quinnipiac contingent I've seen in many, many years. And by the way, getting a little bit of heat from the other colleges and universities and schools, I think Mike has won the first prize in marching at least three or four of the last years. So they think it's an inside deal at this point, since I happen to be vice chairman of the parade. But that, too, again, is a source of great pride for me. So, listen, I'm delighted all of you are here. The last thing you want to do is hear a speech on St. Patrick's Day. Enjoy the food and drinks, and thanks again for coming.